Antony's speech. Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears. I come to brief Caesar, not to praise him. The evil that men do lives after them, the good is often interred with their bones. So, let it be with Caesar. The noble Brutus hath told you Caesar was ambitious. If it were so, it was a grievous fault, and grievously hath Caesar answered it. Here, under leave of Brutus and the rest, for Brutus is an honorable man, so are they all honorable men, come, I to speak in Caesar's funeral. He was my friend, faithful and just to me, but Brutus says he was ambitious, and Brutus is an honorable man. He hath brought many captives home to Rome, whose ransoms did the general coffers fill. Did this in Caesar seem ambitious? When that the poor have cried, Caesar's hath wept. Ambition should be made of sterner stuff. Yet Brutus says he was ambitious, and Brutus is an honorable man. You all did see that on the Lupercal I thrice presented him a kingly crown, which he did thrice refuse. Was this ambition? Yet Brutus says he was ambitious, and sure he is an honorable man. I speak not to disprove what Brutus spoke, but here I am to speak what I do know. You all did love him once, not without cause. What cause withholds you then to mourn for him? O judgment, thou art fell to brutish beasts, and men have lost the reason. Bear with me, my heart is in the coffin there with Caesar, and I must pause till it comes back to me. Antony's speech is an extract from Julius Caesar, one of the famous play written by William Shakespeare. This is the famous speech and popular sense from Julius Caesar. The speech is delivered by Mark Antony, who was a friend of Julius Caesar, the Roman Emperor. This is a rousing speech given to the public while keeping the dead body of Caesar before the public. Antony begins his speech by addressing the public friendly Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears. Throughout his speech, he praises Brutus, but the message Antony conveyed was different. He doesn't mean it. He continues his speech by saying that he came to bury Caesar and not to praise him. The evil deeds done by men live after their death also, but good is often buried with their death. It might be the same with Caesar. Antony's message was that Caesar was a noble man, but Brutus says he was ambitious. Antony established Caesar's nobility by giving instance from his life as a king. Antony said that he did not want to disprove what Brutus said, but the real intention was to praise Caesar with proper reason. if there is reason, they have no reason to step mourning the death of Caesar. He blamed Judge for going to British peace. He concluded the speech that his heart was with Caesar and therefore he had to pause till it came back. The real meaning of this was he would wait till the person who was just like Caesar came. Then he would support him. Let us see some hard words and their meanings. Of, often. Interred, buried. Hath, has. Grievous, very severe or serious. Answered, paid for something. Under leave of, with the permission of. Captives, person who have been taken prisoner or confined. Ransom, the sum of money demanded or paid for the release of a prisoner. General coffers, national treasury. Sterner, cruel or unkind. The Luprical, the Luprical feast day, it is a festival. Withhold, suppress or restrain. Mourn, feel deep sorrow following the death. Tau, you. Artfeld, have run away. Brutish, cruel or like an animal. Coffin, a long narrow box in which a dead body is buried or cremated. Pause, make a brief stop.
మా వీడియో గనుక మీకు నచ్చినట్లయితే లైక్ చేయండి, షేర్ చేయండి. ఇలాంటి మరిన్ని వీడియోస్ కోసం మా ఛానల్ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకోవడం మాత్రం మర్చిపోకండి. థ్యాంక్ యూ ఫర్ వాచింగ్.